Alright, so we got lava run then, hey?
Metal films! Look towards the end of the lava field. You will see the exit. That is where you must end.
Oh, okay. Right, whoop. Let me get it back up there. Crouch. Oh, okay. That's where I've got to head to. And I don't want to get burnt around there now, do I?
Metal films! I was going to tell you that something is different this time, but I'm just going to do it and not tell you. The listeners will be able to hear it. We're going to be running a commentary, audio commentary, a commentator's perspective.
Oh, and hello and welcome to Minecraft. What we've got here is the quest for the G, and we're seeing how Matto gets across here. We're heading towards the other side for the exit. With me today, we've got our good mate Bruce. He's a sheep farmer from down the coast. He will be helping me out. Say hello, Bruce.
G'day. How you going? Bruce here.
Thank you, Bruce. Thank you very much. And so we're going to check out what this bloke does, and we'll see how silly he gets. I reckon we should run a bet. It definitely looks like we're going for some iron here. I believe we will be getting the iron to make shoes, possibly. What do you think of that, Bruce?
Yeah, mate. I reckon that he could be going to get that iron to make some shoes. But we will have to wait and see.
Yes, thank you, Bruce. Thank you very much for that help. So he's putting down some pink blocks there. Pink wool. Lava pink wool. Do you reckon that goes well together, Bruce?
I would say not, because wool burns when it gets near fire. And lava is kind of like a fire, so if lava and wool touch each other, yes, it will burn.
Thank you, Bruce. Thank you for that. So what have we got here? He's he's discovered that he's got enough coal, iron, to make the shoes. Will he make the crafting bench now? Let's have a look at here. See, there's a bit of smoke coming up there. I would say it's getting a bit hot there. What's he doing here? What does it look like? He's putting more. Oh, look, see, there we go. The wall is on fire.
Yeah, that's what I reckon. He's got too close to that lava, and the wall's caught alight because wall and lava don't mix too well.
Yes, thank you, Bruce. Thank you for that. Okay, so it looks like he's getting some cobblestone. I think we're looking at getting some building stones to help him make a bridge or get across. Do you think that maybe he might stop all the lava?
I would say that would be a big task. I've never myself put out lava, as there's not much lava where I come from, and it would probably burn the sheep if there was lava. But no, I don't know.
Thank you, Bruce. Thank you for that. So it looks like we're going up here. We've gone up. He's getting awfully close to that lava. That's getting a little bit scary. We don't want it all over. No, he's going in. He's venturing into the wall. There's lava drops around there, and he's digging above. That's a big no-no. What do you think of that, Bruce, digging above?
Yeah, look, nah, I don't think he should be digging above, because if there is lava above him and he digs that out, it could come down on top of him and burn him, and that would be game over.
Thank you, Bruce. Yes, well, we don't want game over, do we? Because what are we up to? Quest number six, I think this one is. So we've come through some pretty epic places. This is definitely one of the most scariest looking places so far. A lot of lava, a lot of chances of being burnt. Looks like he's filling in a bit here. He's having a bit of trouble. We've made steps. We're going up, yes. Oh, look. He is capping off the lava. Will he finish it all off? Will he stop the lava flow? I don't know. Look at that. There's a big sand contraption there. He could drop those. Oh, and there's glowstone over there. Oh, he's missing a lot there. I hope he's picking all this up. I think... What do you reckon, Bruce? Does it look like he's honing in on stopping it all? Or is he tuned in on getting towards the end? I would say he's having a good look around, but it does look like he's putting some lava out there. Long as he's careful and doesn't get burnt, it'll be okay. Thank you again, Bruce. Thank you. It's invaluable that you are with us today. And I'd like to say a big congratulations on your company so far. I hear it's going quite well, Bruce. Yes, it's picking up all right. Thank you very much. I am being a bit of a celebrity and all, and I'm just getting used to it, you could say. Thank you, Bruce. Thank you. Well, looks like we're at the top of the chasm here, right at the top. Do you think he might punch through to the top? That looks like it could be an easy way out. There is definitely glowstone over there. I would imagine that we're going to go and get that glowstone over the other side. I'm not sure if he knows. We do have a bit of inside information on what he does need. I don't know how much we can give away without the voice coming back and telling us off. But I know that he does need some glowstone. We will leave it at that and not say any more. Hey, Bruce. Yes, I think we should not say too much because the voice does scare me a little bit. Okay, Bruce, well, we will... Oh, look! He's just discovered the chest. Aha! Now, he's got all the way up to the top, and he's seen that there's a chest down there. What do you think he's going to do? Is he going to go get the chest? I think that he would go get the chest because he won't be able to refuse it. It could be something good in there. Yes, Bruce. Yes. Definitely could be something good. And he's getting across. As long as he doesn't stuff up here and burn the chest. Diverting the lava flow and going on top of the chest. That'd be not a very good move, I believe, there. Looks like we've moved over to the other side of the chasm, so we're now on the right side. If we were at the back looking towards the exit, we were on the right side of the chasm. We initially started off on the left. We, I say loosely, as in Matt is actually the one playing and digging. He's the one doing the quest. We're just commentating on it. Looks like we've got a bit of a room happening here. I think we could be doing a bit of crafting coming up. Or is he just collecting blocks? It doesn't look like he knows what he's doing. No, he's filling in a hole. Okay, so we've just filled in a hole. That's pretty spectacular. No, we're heading back in. No, we're not. I thought we were going to be doing some crafting. It looks like we're back to lava filling in again. Okay. Look. He's just seen there's more iron there. The chest is still there. I see the chest still down there. We're back to the left-hand side. That's the left-hand side as if when we started from looking towards the exit. That is the left-hand side. And we're well over halfway towards the exit, I would imagine. But that chest is probably going to set him back a little bit. That looked like it could have been on fire there, Bruce. The chest down there. Yes, I did see that. But it looks like he is going for that iron in the ground. Oh, I think that is mainly his importantness at the moment. Yes, thank you, Bruce. Thank you for the importantness. Yes, I would say he's definitely looks like he's going for that iron. And out comes the pickaxe, and there goes the iron. There's one piece. There's another piece. I see another three pieces down there. Okay, yes, so we've got five pieces all up out of that nice dig. As long as he's careful there, he hasn't dropped in. He's building a staircase. Oh, he's being very, very gentle with it. Oh, that looks a bit... Get out of there. I would be moving now. No, he's not in a hurry. He's taking his time. There he goes. He was lucky. I thought that lava might have been coming on through there. Still on the left-hand side, looking at it, and there's the chest. Okay, so we're moving downwards slowly. And I think he's definitely beelining for that chest. He's collected a fair few cobblestones. He's lining up backwards. He's got the creep on. He's got the first block in. Then here comes the second block. The second block is in. He is moving across the chasm now. Second block in. There comes the third. He's checking around. Third, fourth block is in. Checking the space in between. Can he go through? No problems. Yes, here comes the last block to join up the left and right sides of the chasm. And he is across. Oh, well done. A big hand of applause there. Thank you very much. Well done. I think we might have said we were on the right-hand side before when we weren't. So there's a little bit of falseness to it. Oh, and now we're dropping sand into the lava. Oh, you better be careful here. Yeah, it's creeping out. I think we could see a bit of a burn episode going on here if he's not careful. No. Yes, look at that. It's out. He's running. He's run away. And it's coming down. That's it. It's coming down. And he's dug his way into a nice little hidey hole there. Very safe. Very well done. And I believe, yes, he's going to come back and patch all that up. That's very good. And I think, yes, we can see the chest. No, we cannot see the chest, so we're going to wait till some of this lava goes out before we can see the chest. And that's going to be the end of episode 6. Tune in next week for episode 7, where we go and find that chest and open it and see what's in it. Thank you very much for watching, and stay tuned.